Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Pat Leonard and this is my colleague Celia Sabato. And your names are?
My name is Lara.
And your?
My name is Mateo.
Mm-hmm. And your name?
My name is Agustina.
Can I have your mark sheets, please?
Yes.
Thank you. First of all, we'd like to know something about you. Lara, where do you live?
I live in Buenos Aires, Argentina.
And you?
I live in Buenos Aires, Argentina as well.
Uh-huh. And you, Agustina?
I live in Buenos Aires, Argentina too.
Mm-hmm. Agustina, what sports do you enjoy playing?
I didn't play nothing at the now, but I really enjoy playing volleyball because I think playing in a group it's a very good idea.
Mm-hmm, thank you. Lara, do you ever meet your friends in the evenings after school?
Yes, we always go to have lunch or maybe have a good time at the shopping mall, or maybe we're not big fans of hanging out at the school days, but when we can, we always hang out.
Mm-hmm. Mateo, do you prefer to spend time with your family or with your friends at the weekend?
I prefer to spend time with my friends at the weekend because I already see my family enough and I don't see them as much.
Mm-hmm. And can you tell us something about what you are planning to do next weekend?
Yes, next weekend I'm planning to go to my family's house in Palermo and spend Easter there.
Mm-hmm. Agustina, is there something that you'd like to learn in the future?
Yes, I already know what I going to be. I think that be a community manager, it's my
future. And Lara, what would you like to do when you leave school?
Oh, when I leave school, I'll probably take a year for myself because school is already draining me, and I would like to have a year for myself and hanging out with the people I like. And after that, I would like to start studying a career. Probably, I would like to be a teacher.
Thank you. In this part of the test, I'm going to give each of you two photographs. I'd like you to talk about your photographs on your own for about a minute, and also to answer a short question about your partner's photographs. Lara, it's your turn first. Here are your photographs. They show people eating together in different places.
Okay.
I'd like you to compare the photographs and say why the people have decided to eat together in these places, all right?
Mm-hmm. So in both of these pictures, I can see two groups of people talking and hanging out. In the first one, I can see a group of friends, maybe at the school cafeteria, hanging out, laughing, and eating their food. In the second picture, I can see a family, probably celebrating or having a good time at the park. The first one is probably a cafeteria, since it has machines in the back and big tables. While the second one is probably a park, since it has grass and they are in a blanket. These people probably decided to eat together in these situations. In the first one, probably because they are students and they want to hang out after school or maybe in the breaks. In the second one, they probably decided to eat together since they are a family and want to hang out. In the second one, they are laughing and having a good time. It also shows that it's a very nice day. While in the first one, it's a close-up.
Thank you. Mateo, do you often eat out with friends?
Yes, I normally eat out with friends. I enjoy spending time after school, and we go normally to different places.
Thank you. Mateo, now here are your photographs. They show people working hard in different situations.
Yes.
I'd like you to compare the photographs and say what you think they might find difficult about working hard in these situations.
Yes.
All right?
The first picture shows a girl in a library studying, and she's surrounded by books and probably learning about a subject. And the second picture shows some gardeners helping plant a tree. They're in a group, so they might be with friends or like co-workers. Then the first picture, I think she chose the library because it's quieter, maybe there's her house. And I think that she's what she finds working hard about this situation is like the subject she's learning about, or maybe the exam itself. And in the second picture, it's a lot of hard work, and they are working out as well while they're planting the tree to dig, and yeah.
Thank you. Agustina, do you ever go to a library to work?
No, I never went there because I think my house is quiet than the library.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Now, here are your photographs. They show people learning to do new things. I'd like you to compare the photographs and say why you think the people are learning to do these things. All right?
Yes. The first picture shows a child with her father, and he's teaching him how to repair the car. And picture two shows a child with her mom, and she's teaching her how to cook. And I think they are teaching them this because if the boy travels alone and the car broke, he can repair it alone. And in picture two, I think she's teaching her this because if she goes with her grandmother someday or something like that, she can cook her something.
Okay, thank you. Lara, would you like to learn how to cook?
Yeah, I'm a really big fan of cooking and trying new food, so I'm always open to learning how to cook.
Thank you. Well, now I'd like you to talk about something together for about 3 minutes. Here are some things that many people believe are important if students want to feel happy at school, and a question for you to discuss. First, you have some time to look at the task. Now, talk to each other about how important these things are if students want to feel happy at school.
Okay, would you like to start, Lara?
Yeah, for sure. I think the most important thing to feel happy at school for students will be having good friends, always hanging out with them, and also they make school less stressful than already it is. What's your opinion about it?
Yeah, I agree with you.
I agree. But I think the having... No, sorry. Doing things after school or activities, it's important too because you can do another thing and let you think about another things.
Yeah, I agree with you. I think that expanding your friend group and your social life as well, you can partake in after school activities. And I also think that friendly teachers are really important when it comes to schools and students' happiness. Because if their teachers are friendly and are nice to them, they might want to learn more about the subject or expand more of their knowledge about it.
Yeah, you're really right. I also think school rules should be really important. Since a student could be having a bad time, you could always talk to a teacher or the school's principal to talk about the rules, and they may help you out. What do you think?
Sorry.
would you like to start?
No.
Okay. I don't agree with that. I think that there are much more important things than school rules.
I agree with you because if school rules don't like you, you don't get at school.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah. yeah.
But what if there weren't any school rules? You shouldn't be really enjoying school.
No, any. So, if you don't like it, you're not going to that school.
Yeah, I agree with that. I also think that subjects that they enjoy are important, as they might want to go to school and look forward to having a certain subject. And that might, yeah.
Yeah, all of these are really important, but I think the most important one, as I said before, is good friends.
I agree with you.
I agree that, yeah, I agree with that. But yeah, I agree with that. I think that it's the most important good friend. But I think that like the least important one is school rules, as I don't see them helping with the schools, with the students' happiness a lot, but more with the school and keeping it together.
Not really. School rules really help the students. What if someone is bullying another person? They should talk to a principal and tell them there is a rule not to bully.
Yeah.
Yes. You're
and if right. there weren't any rules you're about right. it, they could be really sad or they wouldn't be enjoying school.
You're right.
You're right. But bullying is still going on.
Thank you. Now you have about a minute to decide which is the most important thing that makes students feel happy at school.
As a student, all of this stuff makes me feel happy, but I think the most important one is having good friends.
I agree with you.
I agree with that, but personally, in school, I have more friends outside of school because of my after-school activities than in school. And I think that the friendly teachers are the most important thing to me personally.
Why?
Because all of my teachers are really great and they want me and they help me want to go to school and learn and put focus to it.
Yes, if you don't have friendly teachers, you're not going to understand nothing about the subject.
Yeah, I agree with you.
Yeah, maybe. Well, I still think the best one is having good friends.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you. Agustina, do you think most students in Argentina feel happy about going to school every day?
No, because we have to wake up earlier in the morning and we want to sleep a little more.
Mm-hmm. What's your opinion?
Yeah, I think she's really right. I always have dinner at like 10 or 11 p.m. and it just isn't enough time for me to sleep and wake up really early.
Mm-hmm. And do you think it's true that it takes a long time to feel happy when you start a new school?
Yeah, I really do. When you start a new school, it's like a new start, a fresh start for you. And it's hard for finding new friends and also being at day with your subject. So I think it's really hard, but you always can adapt to it.
Do you agree, Mateo?
Yeah, I agree with her that I think that it can be hard moving to a new school, especially at the half of the year, but you can eventually adapt to it.
Mm-hmm. And some people say that students should be allowed to choose what they want to study. What do you think?
I do not agree with that. I think that they could choose, if they could choose whatever they would like, they wouldn't choose any important subjects like math or biology. I think they all should have like basic levels knowledge of every subject in school.
What's your opinion, Agustina?
I agree with him because in my school, English have no levels, so we are all studying the same, and it's boring for me.
Mm-hmm. Should schools give students longer breaks during the day?
Yes.
I definitely think they should, too.
I also do. Some classes may be really draining for your brain, so having a long break, like from 20 to 30 minutes, will really help as students. We could have a snack or maybe just sit and talk together.
Yeah, I agree with her. I think that you should like rest and prepare yourself for the next period, especially if you have a test or something.
Yes, and sometimes the buffet doesn't have time to get us something to drink or eat.
Yeah, and it has a lot of long lines as well.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you think it's a good idea for schools to organize trips to interesting places during the school day?
Sorry, can you repeat?
Sure. Do you think it's a good idea for schools to organize trips to interesting places during the school day?
Yes, of course, because if you get out of school with your friends and your teachers, you could learn a lot of, and you can go to the museum or something like that, and you are going to understand more the subject.
Yeah, I agree with her. I think that going on school trips to museums or art galleries could be definitely more interesting for the students or for the people that aren't interested in the subject to lean more into learning about it.
Oh, I also do agree with both of them. I think going to a museum, going to a park, or going to a really important place is much better to get out of the book and stop seeing the pictures and see them in person.
Mm-hmm. Should schools give prizes to good students at the end of the year?
Yes. Yeah.
Yes, of course.
I definitely think that they should get something because of their hard work, and I think there should be like best grades or best partner.
Yes.
I think every student should receive a prize for the hard work in school, and also getting up so early may be draining for most of us. So a prize is a really nice way of the school to show to students that they really made a long way to get where they are. Yeah. So,
to show
students should get prizes.
Yes, and if the school doesn't give you something, you're not going to, I don't know how said.
Want to keep on hard
work. Keep on doing hard work
and studying, if like it's the same as the people that don't do any hard work in it, you might give up perhaps.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the prizes maybe will make you feel more valuable, and it's a nice way to show
appreciation.
It's a nice way to show that you really made a hard work to get where you are.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much. That is the end of your test.
Okay.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.